Hello everyone, welcome to the session. In the previous videos, we have seen what is a single linked list and what are the operations that we can perform on the single linked list. Now in this video, I'll explain how to write the complete program, complete menu driven program for implementing all the operations of single linked list. Let's move to the program first. Okay, first of all, whatever library files that are required for your program, you have to include that file. So here I am including stdlib.h file. This stdlib.h file contains implementation for malloc and free functions. So in our program, we have to allocate the memory for the nodes by using malloc, and we need to deallocate the memory from the nodes by using free functions. So those two functions are available in stdlib.h file. Here we are implementing single linked list operations. So this is the node structure for single linked list. Single linked list node structure contains two parts. One is data part and another one is address of next node. Okay, so here for pointing to the first node, here I am taking head pointer. I am assuming that initially list is empty. That is the reason why I am initializing head pointer to null. And here I am taking one more pointer PTR for traversing purpose. In future, at the time of inserting node at the end or in the middle, we need to move to the specified position. That is the reason why here I am taking one extra pointer for traversing purpose. Let us see the insertion operation. So quickly I'll write the code for insertion. If you are unable to follow the class, you just watch the previous videos. In the previous videos, I have explained how to insert the node in the middle, all three cases. Okay. First of all, if you want to perform the insertion operation, we need to check where to insert the element. So now I want to insert the element in the beginning position. Whatever value I want to insert, I am passing it as a parameter. Okay. First of all, we need to check whether the list is empty or not. If list is empty, our inserting element will be the first element as well as last element. Okay. So here, before checking whether the list is empty or not, first, whatever node you want to insert, create the memory for that node. So here my node name is temp, struct node star temp. Allocate the memory for that temp by using malloc function, temp equal to struct node star malloc size of struct node size of struct node. Okay, next, store the data, whatever data you want to store in the node, store the data in the data part of the node. Here I am passing data in the form of value. As a parameter, that value will be stored in the value, variable value, the data I am writing, right? Initially, I am placing null value in the next part of the temp, right? Now I am verifying whether the list is empty or not. If list is empty, our inserting node will be the head node as well as last node. If the list is not empty, then we should insert our node before the head node. Okay, so temp next equal to temp next. In previous we have null value. Now in temp next, we should place head value. Okay, move head to the next position. After placing the head address in the temp next, make our temp node as a head node. So these are the two statements for inserting the node in the begin position. So if you have any doubt in this, you just watch the previous video. Now I want to insert node at the end. Okay, as usual, if you want to insert the node at the end, first of all, you have to create that node and you have to check whether the list is empty or not. Right? I am just copying that node code here. First, I am creating the node, one pointer temp. For that node, I am allocating the memory by using malloc function. Then I am storing the data in the data part. Then I am setting the next value as null. Initially, if next head is null, our inserting node will be the first node as well as last node. If the list is not null, then where to insert? We should insert our node at the end of the list. Okay, so how to find out the end of the node in the list? Okay, if any node next pointer, if any node next pointer is pointing null value, that indicates that that is our the last node. Okay, so just now I told you, if you want to reach the last node, we need one pointer. So already I have declared that pointer in the beginning itself. That pointer name is PTR. Now I am using that PTR to move till the end. Okay, why? PTR next not equal to null. Then what we need to do? PTR next not equal to null means PTR is not the last node. If PTR is not the last node, we should move PTR to the next address or next position. Okay, so from where we should start this traversing? From the first position. That is the reason why initialize head to PTR to the head address, then check PTR next is null or not. If PTR next is not null, move PTR to the next position. If PTR is null, then what we need to do? After PTR, we should insert our temp node. So PTR next equal to our temp. Okay, now successfully the connection established between last node and the temp node. Now we should save, after insertion of temp, after PTR, our temp is the last node in the list. So last node in the list should have null value. Already we have placed null value here in the last next field. Okay, if you want, you can place it here. No problem. Okay, even if you write there also, there is no problem. Nothing wrong in that. Okay, it will not return any error. Right? Now, close the else block. Close the else block and close the insert end function. Now, see the next case. How to insert node at the specified position? How to insert node at the specified position? Okay, suppose I want to insert, node after the specified position. Suppose in my list I have 5 elements, 10 20 30 40. I want to insert after 10, after element 10. Okay, so that is the reason why here my function name is insert after specified element. Here also same, whatever value you want to insert, first of all we should create the node structure, and in that node structure data part we should save the value. Next, check whether the list is empty or not. If the list is empty, that means if head is null, list is empty, our inserting node will be the last node as well as first node. If list is not empty, then what we need to do? We need to place our node after the specified element. Okay, so first of all, we should reach till the specified element. That is the reason why just take the PTR help, assign PTR to the head address and move PTR till the specified position. Okay, so how to move PTR data? Now here we need to compare with the data. Why? Because we are comparing with the element. So while PTR data not equal to our element, here we should pass element also as a parameter. Both the two parameters we should pass. First one is what value you want to insert. Second value is after which element you want to insert. Okay, so here while PTR data, our PTR data is not equal to the element, then what we need to do? We need to move PTR to the next position. Suppose if you want to insert 20 after 10, then what we need to do? First of all, we should find out 10, then we should insert 20 after 10. Okay, so for finding 20, here I am using PTR. Right, if PTR data is not equal to element, move PTR to the next position. If you find the element, then what we need to do? So in temp next we should place PTR next address, and in PTR next we should place temp address. These are the two statements we need to write off for insertion of the node after the specified element. Right, now close the else block and close the insert after function. So these are the three insertion functions. Let us write the delete function. Void delete. First case is begin. Void delete begin. Okay. Here also same. If the list is empty, we can't delete the deletion is not possible. If the list contains some elements, if list is empty, printf list is empty, deletion is not possible. If list contains some elements, then only we can delete it from the list. If the list contains some elements, then what we need to do? First element we are doing. First element we are deleting. So here also, first element is pointed by the head pointer. Directly, if you remove the first element, we will lose the connection of head pointer also, because we should not remove the head pointer. We should, after deletion, second element becomes the head element. That is the reason why we should move head pointer to the next position. Then we should move the first element. So if you move head pointer to the first second position, who will point to the first node? So there is no pointer, right? That is the reason why here also take the help of PTR, assign PTR to the head position, right? Assign PTR to the head position. Then move head to the head next. Move head to the head next. Okay, automatically second node becomes the head node now after executing the statement. Second node becomes head node. Now place the null value in the next part of, place the null value in the next part of PTR. Okay, after making the second element as head element, we should remove first node, second node address in the first node next part. First node is pointed by PTR. That is the reason why place PTR, place null value in the PTR next. Now the connection is disconnected between PTR and the list. So now remove the memory from the PTR by calling free function. So this is the function for inserting the node in the begin position. Now see how to insert the node at the end. Okay. Now see how to insert node at the end position. Here also same. If you want to delete the nodes from the end or from the beginning or in the middle, first of all you have to check whether the list is empty or not. If list is empty, deletion is not possible. If list contains some elements, then only we can delete it. Right? Now our case is deleting last node. If you want to delete the last node, first of all, we should find out the first last node in the list. That is the reason why anyway we are using PTR. Okay. So here we need to, if you move PTR till the last end, PTR points to the last node. But before deletion, we should place PTR previous node next part as null. That is the reason why we need one more pointer for pointing PTR previous node. Okay, deleting node, previous node. Okay, so that is the reason why take one more node. Take one more pointer. Here I am taking P. Okay, first put the head pointer in the, put the PTR in the first position. Now check whether PTR next is null or not. If PTR next is not null, that means that PTR is not a last node. PTR is not a last node. Okay, so before moving to the PTR to the next position, you just give the PTR address to the P. Why? Because if PTR is pointing last node, P should point last but one node. That is the reason why before moving PTR to the next position, assign PTR address to the P. Now move PTR to the next position. When we should move PTR to the next position? When PTR is not a last node. Suppose when PTR is a last node, then what we need to do? We need to disconnect PTR from the P. So in P next, we should place null value. If you place null value in the P next, automatically the connection between P and PTR will be disconnected. Now remove PTR by using free function. So this is the way to delete the node from the end. Let us see the next case. If you want to delete node from the middle, okay, if you want to delete middle node of the list, here also same. First of all, you should check whether the list is empty or not. If list is empty, deletion is not possible. If list contains some elements, then only we can delete the element. Now we should specify which element you want to delete. Which element you want to delete? Suppose in my list I have 3 elements, 10, 20, 30. Now I want to delete 20, right? So that element also I need to know, right? So ask the user about the element, which element he wants to delete. Now compare whether that PTR data is element or not. Okay, so anyway we have taken one pointer for checking or for traversing from one position to another position. So here I am using same pointer PTR. I am checking whether PTR data is equal to deleting element or not. If PTR data is not deleting element, move PTR to the next position. Right? Move PTR to the next position. Suppose if PTR data is the deleting element, then what we need to do? We need to disconnect the links between before PTR node, disconnect the link with the PTR before node and PTR after node. Okay, so how to refer the PTR before node? We don't have any pointer to go back to the previous node. That is the reason why what we need to do here is take one more pointer P, struct node star P. Okay, so start comparison the PTR from the head position. Now before moving, if the data is not the actual deleting element, move PTR to the next position. But before moving PTR to the next position, give that PTR address to the P so that we can identify the previous node of the deleting element. Okay, suppose if you reach the specified position, then what we need to do is in P next, we should place PTR next. In P next, we should place PTR next. Then free the memory from the PTR. This is the simple statement for removing the node from the single linked list from the middle. Right? So these are the insertion, deletion and insertion deletion operations. Let us see how to write the display function. See the display operation. So here, first of all, if you want to display something, list should have some element, some nodes. If the list is empty, we can't display anything, right? So first check whether the list is empty or not. If list is empty, if head equal to null, that indicates that list is empty. If head is not equal to null, then there are some elements in the head. Now take one pointer. Okay, take one pointer to traverse till the end of the list. While traversing, you have to print all the node contents. So already we have taken PTR. So just to start PTR from the head position. Now check the condition. Why? PTR not equal to null. PTR not equal to null means if PTR address is not null. PTR address is not null. Then what we need to do? Move PTR to the next position. PTR equal to PTR next. But before moving PTR to the next node, we should print PTR data, right? So before this PTR, this statement, you just write one printf statement for printing PTR data. Okay. Suppose we are initially we are in the first node position. We have assigned PTR to the head. So we are in the first node position. Now we are checking. First node position means first node address we are storing in PTR. PTR not equal to null. PTR address is not null. It is having first node address. So print PTR data. So print first node data. Then move PTR to the next node. Move PTR to the second position. Right? So this loop will repeats until all the nodes are printed on the screen, including the last node. If you want to include some space between the nodes, you just write printf statement. One more printf statement, including new line character. So this is the display function. Close else and close display function. Okay, with this all the operations are over. Let us see the menu program, main program. Void main. This is important because anyway all those six functions are there in the previous videos also. From here you have to understand. So here I am writing menu. In that menu I am listing all the functions what I am writing here. Okay, insert, begin, insert, end, insert, after. Okay, you have to, user has to choose which function he wants to execute. So for choosing that option, here I am taking on variable choice. Right, now write the menu, printf choice 1, insert begin. If you want to write it in new line, you can write it. Otherwise, in the single line itself, you can write. Okay, second option, insert end. Now third option, insert after specified position. Insert after specified element. Okay. Next, fourth option, delete begin. Now fifth option, delete last node or delete end. Now sixth, sixth option for deleting middle node. Now seventh option is for exit. Okay, seventh for exit. Okay, let us see the main loop. While, here I am taking while loop. Okay, so first of all we should ask the user to enter his choice. Printf enter the choice. Okay, we should accept that choice from the user. So scanf %d %ch, whatever choice the user is entering, either 1 or 2 or 3, the choice will be stored in the variable ch. Now write the switch case. Switch choice, or write the cases. Case 1, what is the case 1? Insert begin. Okay, here we should ask the user which element he wants to insert. Enter the value. Whatever value the user is entering, that we should read, right? So scanf statement %d %value. Okay, now call the insert begin function by passing this value. Okay, after inserting, if you want to see the list after insertion, just call the display function. Then break, close the case 1. Next, write case 2. What is case 2? Case 2 is same, but insert end. Okay, just call insert end function. Now case 3. Case 3 is same, but insert after specified location. Insert after specified element. Okay, I should write function name here. Suppose if I write function name mistake, then it will return the error. So here I am copying the function name instead of making typo errors. I am just copying. Insert after specified element. Okay, so after which element you want to insert, that is also we should read, right? So ask the users to enter the position. Enter the position after which element you want to insert. That position we are saving it in the ELE. So we are calling insert after function. Now case 4 is delete begin. Okay, so here for deletion function, no need to pass the values. Delete begin, call the display function after deletion. Now case 5 is delete end. Just for saving the time, I am copying. Okay, I am copy paste. Delete end. Now next, sixth case. What is the sixth case? Sixth case is for delete middle. So here in delete middle, we should know which element we want to delete. Okay, so here we are passing an element, which element the user wants to delete. So that element we should read it from the user, right? So here we should ask the user to enter which element he wants to delete. Printf, enter the element you want to delete. Suppose if he enters 30 will be deleted from the list. So that element also we should pass ELE. Okay, now case 7 is for exit. Exit of 0, that's all. Okay, all 7 cases are over. Now close the switch block. Close switch, this is the close for switch, this is close for while, and this is close for main method. Now run the program. First of all, we should save the program. So here I am saving it on the desktop, sll1.c. okay, I should save with .c extension. Save. Right, now compile the program. Search for the errors. Yes, here we have the error, like in main function value undeclared. Very good. Here value we have not yet declared. Okay, so we'll declare the value in the main method at the time of declaring ch value, and ele also we should declare, right? Save. Yes, again some errors. Too many parameters. Yes, while calling, no need to use the data types. Directly we should pass the value, because I have copied the while copying the name, I have copied parameters also. That is the mistake here. Compile. Yes, still one more error. Expected identifier token. Okay, this is extra. Compile it. Yes, there are no errors. Okay, now check the output. I am inserting first case, insert the element 10. Okay, 10 successfully inserted. Again I am checking insert begin. Now I am inserting 5 also inserted successfully. Second option, insert end. I want to insert 20 after 10. Yes, successfully inserted. Now I want to check after specified element. Okay, option 3. Which element I want to insert? I want to insert 15 after 10. Okay, so 15 placed after 10 successfully. Now I want to delete the first element. Which is the first element? 5. So 4, option choice is 4. Delete begin choice is 4. 4. So 5 is deleted. Now I want to delete the end element. Option is 5. Now 20 is successfully deleted. Right? Now for checking the middle element, I need to have some elements. So I am inserting one more element. Like I am inserting at end 30. And I am inserting one more element 40. Now the list is 10, 15, 30, 40. Now I want to insert the middle element. Okay, so choice is 6. Which element you want to delete? I want to delete 15. Yes, 15 successfully deleted from the list. Final list is 10, 30, 40. Now I want to delete one more middle element, 30. Okay, now I want to delete 30. Yes, successfully deleted. The list is 10 and 40 after deletion of middle element. Now option 7, exit. So this is the single linked list menu program. Right? So in the next session, I'll explain how to implement the double linked list with complete program.